Sierra Jamison was found unresponsive in her garage on Monday evening. The young mother of one had been strangled to death. Tonight, Chicago police have one person in custody related to her murder as friends and family gathered to remember the young life taken too soon.
God, please help us. Help us help each other.
A large group gathered in Garfield Park on Wednesday evening to celebrate the life of Sierra Jamison. 30-year-old Jamison was found unresponsive in the garage of her rental home in the Grand Crossing neighborhood on Monday evening. According to family, Jamison had just moved her mother into the rental home with her, and her mom became concerned when Jamison was not answering her phone.
She finally went through the backyard to go in the garage, and she found my cousin laying on the floor, lifeless.
Jamison's mom called police, and first responders pronounced the 30-year-old dead at the scene. Her death ruled a homicide by the Cook County Medical Examiner, who says she died of strangulation. Jamison's cousin says the loss is devastating to the entire family. The young mother leaves behind a 6-year-old boy who will now be cared for by his grandmother.
He truly took a gift from God away from us, and like, it's beyond sad.
Chicago police have one person in custody related to this crime and tell us that charges are pending. Friends and family we spoke to today say they feel strongly they know who's responsible for Jamison's death, and they believe that person will be brought to justice. In Garfield Park, Alyssa Donovan.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the channel. This is Talking Crime, and my name is Shanira. You guys, I have another story today, and this story is about a young lady named Sierra Jamison. Now, Sierra was born in 1993, and she lived in Chicago, Illinois. Sierra was the age 30, and Sierra had not too long ago celebrated her 30th birthday. Now, Sierra also worked as a phlebotomist on day shift, and she also had a son. I mean, her routine was to go to work and come home and make sure that she's taking care of her son. Her whole goal was to make sure that his future and him was well taken care of. So Sierra focused on working hard for just that. Sierra wanted to become a RN, so her goal was to go back to school, and her goals was coming into action. Sierra also loved family and friends. She was nurturing, loving, and also a warm-hearted person. She enjoyed life, and for the most part, Sierra seemed like she was doing just fine. Unfortunately, Sierra would start dating a man that she had already been friends with for 10 years. She started dating him, and everything for Sierra wind up taking a left turn, causing her life. This is the story of Sierra Jamison. Now, Sierra started dating a guy named Lawrence Boyle, age 63. And it was said that they were friends way before dating, like 10 years or a little over 10 years. But a short while before Sierra would lose her life, her and Lawrence would start dating. Now, Sierra and Lawrence was dating for this short period of time, but a couple of months before that, Sierra would be a victim of a carjacking issue at a gas station. And fortunately, she had women to help her at this situation. And she spoke out after this dramatic situation.
We really got some women that's out here that go stand their ground and fight. Because it was the young lady that was in front of me and the young lady that was at the pump one. They helped me. I wasn't just by myself. They literally stepped in and helped me. It was a lot of black empowerment, women empowerment that day. Because they could have left. They could have just minded their business. But they know. They still right there and they helped me. And I'm blessed. I'm grateful. I went home to my son. I thank God every day that I'm here, because it could have went a different way.
So eerie to hear this young woman's voice just about a month before this all happened. Now, as of this morning, we checked in with Chicago police. They wouldn't confirm whether there was a person of interest in this case. Again, no one is in custody as of this morning. Family is planning on a memorial for her for later on this evening. Reporting outside of CPD headquarters, I'm Marissa Perlman, CBS 2 News.
Now, on September the 18th, 2023, Sierra will call her mother, telling her mother that she was going to park her Jeep in the garage. Now, Sierra hangs up the phone, and her mother thinking that Sierra is doing just that. After a while, Sierra wasn't answering her phone calls or anything, not even responding back, to the point where Sierra's mother tells her brother to go out to the garage and check on Sierra. Now, this was about like at 6:35. Sierra's brother goes out to the garage and he noticed that Lawrence was closing down the garage with Sierra's phone in his hand. So he asks him, where's Sierra? Lawrence tells Sierra's brother that Sierra got frustrated and mad, threw her phone at him, and then walked off like she was going to the store. Even though this seemed odd to Sierra's brother, he went back in the house, telling Sierra's mother. Now, you know how a mother's intuition is and instincts about her child. So Sierra's mother, it didn't sit quite well with her. Sierra's mother goes out to the garage and noticed that Sierra was in the garage and her vehicle. Sierra, lifeless on the ground with a tarp over her body. Immediately, Sierra's mother dials 911 and police arrive on the scene. Sierra's mother was devastated, and she couldn't get the images of seeing her baby girl in the garage on the ground. It was so terrifying. And Sierra's mother knew that something was wrong. Immediately, the police started searching for Lawrence. And get this, he called his ex-wife, confessing to him just strangling a person that he was dating to his ex-wife. Next thing you know, Lawrence was caught, brought in, and he confessed to strangling Sierra. He stated that he thought she had a gun, and when he realized she didn't, he continued to strangle her, taking her life. You guys, this was something scary. Like, this was really scary. First, she had to deal with a person trying to jack her with a knife at a gas station, trying to take her Jeep. Now, she was murdered by the hands of someone that she dated, that supposed to have loved and protect her. Sierra's words after she was almost carjacked was scary to listen to. She stated how women in general is always targeted, especially Black women. And for Sierra's case, this was true. Now, you guys, Lawrence had a list of things that he had done in the past. Now, I'm not sure if Sierra knew this by them being friends for years, but I would say that Lawrence kept this a secret from Sierra. Now, in March of 2011, Lawrence was charged with domestic violence, aggravated assault with a deadly weapon, but the charges were dropped April 2011. Then, in 1993, he was convicted of child abuse in North Carolina, and he served like 6 years. He wound up getting out in 1999, and then he served 2 years for breaking and entering, followed by 1997, a misdemeanor assault. Now, Lawrence had a list of stuff, and this murder was adding to his list. For this murder, he could get life in prison, but he haven't went to trial yet. Family and friends are devastated, heartbroken. And the saddest part is that Sierra had a son that won't even know her once he grow up, because he's young.
Chicago police have one person in custody related to her murder as friends and family gathered to remember the young life taken too soon.
God, please help us. Help us help each other.
A large group gathered in Garfield Park on Wednesday evening to celebrate the life of Sierra Jamison. 30-year-old Jamison was found unresponsive in the garage of her rental home in the Grand Crossing neighborhood on Monday evening. According to family, Jamison had just moved her mother into the rental home with her, and her mom became concerned when Jamison was not answering her phone.
She finally went through the backyard to go in the garage, and she found my cousin laying on the floor, lifeless.
Jamison's mom called police, and first responders pronounced the 30-year-old dead at the scene. Her death ruled a homicide by the Cook County Medical Examiner, who says she died of strangulation. Jamison's cousin says the loss is devastating to the entire family. The young mother leaves behind a 6-year-old boy who will now be cared for by his grandmother.
He truly took a gift from God away from us, and like, it's beyond sad.
The mother and the family was so terrified and devastated. The memory of her finding her daughter in the garage and the memory that her brother will continue to have of that day will forever live on in their minds. Hopefully this family get the justice that Sierra needs, and it will give them a little more closure that he's going to be behind bars, and hopefully for life. You guys, let's keep safe. Let's continue to pray for Sierra's family. Don't forget to like, comment, and definitely subscribe to my channel where we talk crime over here. Peace.